Who's crazier? Me or YouTube? You decide. Some time ago, I got some material together for a video on YouTube, terms of service, and all that sort of jazz. But, you know, through a bit of apathy and a bit of, well, do people really want another video on terms of service? I decided against it and didn't do it. But something else cropped up today, and I thought, you know, what the hell, let's go for it. So I started assembling things together and a few oddities cropped up and I thought, huh? So yeah, here we are recording this. YouTube are getting it in the neck, rightfully so, because their bots are going bonkers. All sorts of things happening are happening, and this one was just took the cake and really provoked me to making this video finally. YouTuber in row over copyright infringement of his own song. Long story short, he's a Dutch YouTuber and he's got popular music videos, and he put a video up and another YouTuber used that music in another video, built on top of it, but then Paul Davids got a copyright strike. So it wasn't the other YouTuber who'd mixed the video up who got the copyright strike. No, it came back on Paul Davids. And basically, he had a bit of a fight and just gave up in the end. He said, I think he said that... something like that. In the end, Paul decided to do the nicest thing he could think of. He let the copycat keep using his song. It's not like he'll make tons of money with it, Paul said. It's okay. It probably happens all the time. The BBC have approached YouTube for comment. Yeah, you can bet... probably nothing quite like lighting a fire under YouTube's arse like the BBC getting in touch. So, we'll see what happens on that, but, yeah, YouTube is just not safe. I mean, even if you are a creator, you can get ripped off and, you know, the person who's ripped you off can wind up getting the glory and you're the one that ends up with a strike. Now, I had a series of notes on various things with the terms of service, and when I was putting this together, I got a bit of a slap in the face. There's one terms of service, and there's another terms of service. Which terms of service are currently in service? I don't know. This terms of service contains a number of things, among which is 2.3. You may not use the service and may not accept the terms if... A. You are not of legal age to form a binding contract with YouTube. Or B. You are a person who is either barred or otherwise legally prohibited from receiving or using the service. And blah, blah, blah. So, how does that square away with all the younger generation that are currently using the service who are not of legal age to form a binding contract with YouTube? And yet you've got YouTube Kids and all the rest of that jazz. That just does not square away. The other one, I'm going by limited notes here because actually some other stuff doesn't add up either, but we'll come on to that. I think it's down section 8 on here. Note this because we'll come to it in the others. Rights you license. When you upload or post content to YouTube, you grant 8.1b to each user of the service a worldwide, non-exclusive, royalty-free license to access your content through the service and to use, reproduce, distribute, prepare derivative works of, display and perform such content to the extent permitted by the functionality of the service and under these terms. That's what got me. To the extent permitted by the functionality of the service. Can you see that? Probably now. So, to me, that reads that if person B has got a video and I want to use sections of their video in mine in order to comment on their video, for example, I can include that because in order to upload, they have to grant that permission, but I can only do it provided that I've inserted their video within YouTube. If I download their video and YouTube doesn't allow me to do it and I do it by some other means and then on my offline editor cut it in and then upload that server back to YouTube, I've gone outside the functionality of the service. So I'd actually be in breach of 8.1b. And 8.1b, by the way, is on these terms of service, which are here. YouTube/T/terms. There's another terms of service, which is here, and that's quite different. One of the things that I was looking for, and what also prompted something else, which I cannot find now, so whether there's possibly a third version of the terms of service floating around, I don't know. Linus Tech Tips got done because they uploaded a video to YouTube so the follower was saying, hey, we're live now on Twitch. And basically what the terms of service that I read, they got done. They got a strike. Now, oddly enough, the strike that they were given took away their live streaming functionality. So the punishment for them telling people that they were live streaming on Twitch was to lose the live streaming functionality on YouTube. Go figure. Yeah. But I did see under the use of service permissions and restrictions that if you are a commercial YouTuber, in other words, you're receiving money from the service, then you can't do that. It's against the, you know, it's not, if you're in a commercial agreement with YouTube, YouTube don't like it if you promote your activities somewhere else and drive the content generating money making content on another service. They don't like that. Understandable. But if you're not commercial like me and not monetized, then that isn't against the service. But I then looked through here and I couldn't find the damn thing again. The closest that I could find is that YouTube hereby grants you permission to access and use the service as set forth, provided that, blah blah, you agree not to use the service for any of the following commercial uses unless you obtain YouTube's prior written permission, and that is the sale of advertising, sponsorships, or promotions placed on or within the service content. That's not as specific as it was. Now, it's possible that this has changed as a result of the Linus Tech Tips stuff. I don't know. But a few other odds and sods made an appearance on here. In that, if I do a search... nope. Let's just get this back out here. Because I've got to cancel that and go on to here. Ah, yeah, here it is. Get this. YouTube reserves the right to decide whether content violates these terms of service for reasons other than copyright infringement, such as, but not limited to, pornography, obscenity, or excessive length. So that's under the account termination policy. So if you're posting videos of excessive length, you can get your account terminated. What is excessive length? Anybody got any idea? And here again, and to use, redistribute, distribute, display, and other under the terms of service, as permitted through the functionality of the service and under these terms of service. That is also there under 6C on this one. Odd. Bonkers. Now, under the community guidelines, you've got harmful and dangerous content, which we'll come back to, and you've also got copyright. Now, under those previous terms of service, it covered that if you upload material, you're granting other users the right to use your blah, 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 blah. In here, respect copyright. Only upload videos that you made or you're authorized to use. That means don't upload videos you didn't make or use content in your videos that someone else owns the copyright to, such as music tracks, snippets of copyright programs, or videos made by other users without necessary authorizations. You could say that the terms of service actually give you the necessary authorizations. Potentially provided you stay within the service. This is a bit bonkers. it's stupid. They're sort of contradicting themselves. They sort of say that you've got to have the snippets of copyrighted programs or videos made by other users. Made by other users implies other users of this platform. Because if they're not of this platform, then they're not users. Because they're not users of this platform, they're other people. And, yeah. So I read other users as other users of the platform. Not other videos elsewhere on other platforms. So this is a bit bonkers. It's not clear. It's contradictory. And what the hell? Now, I did actually provide feedback on that. I gave them a feedback on the terms of service, gave that section of terms of service, and referred them to this copyright. They're just not. It's just all bonkers, really, to be perfectly honest. There are some additional policies which may make you think twice about a few things. Just got to try and work out how long I'm going on this one. Additional policies. Vulgar language. Some language is not appropriate for younger audiences. The use of sexually explicit language or excessive swearing in your video or associated metadata may lead to your video being age-restricted. Note that that is just age-restricted, not banned, or blocked, or removed, or deleted. There is an inactive accounts policy, in which case YouTube can reclaim your account without notice if it's inactive, which may be considered as not logging into the site for at least 6 months, never having uploaded video content, and not actively partaking in watching or commenting on videos or channels. So it can be a case of goodbye your account. So if you've got any sock accounts or any backup accounts, make sure that you keep them active. Otherwise, you could go for them and they could be gone. Encouraging terms of service violations. Now, this one's quite serious. If you post content that encourages other users to violate our terms of service, the content may be removed, your account may be penalized, and in some cases, your account may be terminated. Okay. And age requirements on Google products. Hang on. I prefer the age requirement on Google accounts. Europe. For all countries not listed below, 13 is the minimum age to manage your own Google account. Hang on a minute. So you're saying that in the UK, someone of 13 is able to enter a legally binding contract? Huh? What? Does not compute. Does not compute. Their own terms and service just does not compute. Yeah. Now, anyway, back to the policies on harmful, dangerous content that I was talking about and that I come back to. If you're watching on Vimeo, because I'll post this to both channels, there's a video on cooking on methane. Cooking on methylated spirits. Cooking on methane. Duh. when it was on YouTube, I'd humorously titled it Cooking on Meth, and it was deleted. And I appealed it, and the deletion was upheld, and I had a strike. But according to their own policies, it shouldn't have been deleted. At the very worst, it should have received an age restriction. So they're not even adhering to their own policies. Now, yeah, here we go. What that video contained, if you're watching on YouTube, is a friend and I, so we are both adults. My friend was teaching me how to use a methylated spirit cooker, which is used for camping. It's very useful because traditionally you go with the canister-based stuff, but the canisters are usually specific to the kinds of burner that you've got. And if you happen to run out of gas and the camping site doesn't stock your particular type of canister, you're left with needing backup. And backup is usually something like methylated spirits, which are relatively easy to get hold of. Now, so because I don't use it that often, I needed a refresher course. And the video was about us, my friend teaching me how to use the thing, and I cooked a meal on it. YouTube banned it under the policy of harmful or dangerous content. Videos that we consider to encourage dangerous or illegal activities include instructional bomb making, choking games, hard drug use, well, we didn't exactly snort the stuff, or other acts where serious injury may result. Okay, other acts where serious injury may result. Okay, could be done. We are very sensitive to any harmful or dangerous content that involves minors. It didn't. If your video shows a minor participating in a harmful or dangerous activity, do not post it. Fair enough. In the interest of protecting minors, we may age-restrict videos showing adults participating in activities that have a high risk of injury or death. Okay, fair enough. So it should have been age-restricted. It shouldn't have been deleted, and I shouldn't have had a strike that lost me live view for more than 3 months. And what else happened? I think something else happened as well. You know, the strike lasted 3 months, and, you know, long story short is, they're not even following their own policies. So, what chance does anyone stand? On a service that... Why should anyone start to create their career and put a serious amount of effort into a channel which could be taken away because even if you follow the policies, even if you follow the terms of service, which terms of service depends, you can still get, you know, you can play by the rules. But YouTube aren't playing by the rules. They're not playing by their own rules. Utterly bonkers. So, yeah, that's the long and short of it. Obviously, I'm not in any way a lawyer. I am making my own interpretation of what I'm reading. But to me, this looks like a complete, total and utter mess. It's just a complete shambles. What can you say? So, I'll see you on the next video, YouTube, Vimeo, whatever you're watching me on. I've lost complete track. Anyway, ciao for now.